Chongren Fan joins me now from New York City. He's the artistic director for the Yangtze Repertory Theater of America. Talk to us about this festival and what it's done for China's theater industry. It just seems to grow, and it's really unique, isn't it?
Yes, definitely. It's a very exciting time for theater industry and theater artists in China these days. I think, the past 40 years, China's economy boost really stabilized the middle class, and a lot of families invest largely on arts education, into their kids' life. And my generation really benefit from that. And there are a lot of theater goers these days are young people, and everyone is treating this as a social gathering opportunity. At the same time, theater is a perfect platform, for you to reflect on your own life and to know your neighbor and to be part of the human experience and the storytelling.
And attracting a younger audience, talk to me about technology, because it seems to me it's changing things, and it also seems to be playing a role there in Wuzhen. How significant is it?
New technology, particularly in China these days, are pretty significant in terms of coming into theater. We all know traditional theater, you will see a lot of wooden structures on stage. But these days, with a lot of the new theater being built and a lot of the new lighting equipment, projection system, even sometimes hologram, being used in a theater, it definitely create a new layer of storytelling. We can use no longer just the words and traditional music to tell what's going on stage, but with the a wide range of different equipment, you can do more, definitely.
And you've been in the theater business for some time now in the United States and China. Talk to us about the differences you see and perhaps what China's industry can learn from the U.S. and vice versa.
I think it's a very interesting time, for me, being, I was born and raised in Shanghai, and then I moved here to pursue a career in theater. I would say, the theater business in China is still in its infant stage. The modern Western theater didn't really arrive in China until, the earliest 20th century. And there are still a lot industry-wise infrastructure needs to be built. I'm not talking about hardware. I'm talking about, is there a proper casting process for the actors? Is there a, proper way of communication, between the productions, production team and the creative team? These are, what the U.S. and the West have been doing for years. That's a lot I think the Chinese theater community can learn from the West. But at the same time, I think what the West can learn from China is really bringing in new audience members. When you go on Broadway these days, when you go in there, it's basically just a lot of them are baby boomers. I always tell my American friends, I really think the youth and the younger generation of Chinese audience probably will become the core of the next couple of generations of theater goers and the patrons, and they will be part of the community, and it's very exciting.
Yeah, it'll be fascinating to watch. Thanks so much for your insights. Really appreciate it.